Okay, hello and good day everyone. No? So today we will discuss about presentation of data. Okay, so we have here no classification of data. We have ungrouped data. No? Ungrouped data are data that are not organized or if arranged could only be formed highest to lowest or lowest to highest lang. No? So that is for ungrouped data. Example, we have 11, 12, 15, 17, 20 or in a highest to lowest arrangement 20, 17, 15, 12 and 11, no? So ang group data naman konti lang to, no? Konting data lang, no? Ilang paraso lang, or mga 10 lang pinaka highest diyan na number of datas. Next, for group data naman are data that are organized and arranged into different classes or categories. Example here, ito yung number of datas, then ito naman yung organization of group data. Okay? So, number of classes or categories. Okay? Hindi natin siya pwedeng arrange into highest to lowest, but by in categories. Okay? The next is yung textual method naman, no? It is used when data to be presented is purely qualitative or when very few numbers are involved. This involves enumerating the important characteristics, giving emphasis on significant figures and identifying important features of the data. Example here, no? In a group of 420 high school students in San Isidro National High School, 60% is in favor of RH Bill. Among those 60%, we have 189 are boys. Okay? So that is for textual method. Pag-represent siya ng data in a sentence or in a paragraph form. Okay, textual method ang tawag doon. Next naman is yung tabular method, no? It's a systematic arrangement of data usually arranged in rows or columns for easy reference of information. In short, we use tables here, no, to represent data. By organizing data, important features about the data can be readily understood and comparisons can easily be made. Okay? So here, no, in a statistical table, okay, it has the essential components. We have table heading, column header, row classifier, body, and source note. For table heading, no, consists of the table number and title of the table. Table number is used for easy reference to the table, no. That's why sa mga books, no, sa mga books may mga table 3.2, table 4.5, no. Table number ang tawag doon. Table title naman is used to briefly describe the content of the table, no. So, yun ba, table 1.13, no? The classification of this one, no? Table title ang tawag doon. Column header naman is used to describe the data in each column, no? So, meron niya nakalagay sa may column. Row classifier naman is used to show the classes or categories. Body is the main part of the table, contains quantitative information. A footnote naman may be placed immediately below the main part of the table. So sometimes, no, doon sa mga books, especially sa AP book nyo, na mga, pag may mga table doon na pinapakita, no, in economics, no, kahit sa history, may mga footnote doon sa baba. Okay, yan. A source note naman may also be included to acknowledge the original source of the data. Okay? So here is the example of statistical table, no? Ito, table, I mean, itong dalawang to, itong 3.1 tsaka table on how workers in Metro Manila get to work is known as a table heading. So, yung table number natin dito is yung table 3.1 and then yung table title natin is yung table on how workers in Metro Manila get to work. The row classifier here, ito yun, and then column header, ito naman. Yan, yung pinapakita na yung mga nasa taas. Ito naman yung row classifier. Now, next naman is yung frequency distribution, no, that is belong to the statistical table. It is a table which shows the data arranged into different classes and the number of cases which falls into each class. So sa group data, ito yung ginagamit nating presentation of data or table is yung frequency distribution. As you can see here, nagkakaroon tayo dito ng mga classes and categories. Okay? Here, no? Sa example na to, 3.2, we have table 3.2. yung I natin dito is the interval, no? We have 10. So paano nakuha si 10 as an interval? Bilangin natin from 20 to 29. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. So we have 10 intervals. Okay? Then number of frequency naman, yung N natin is number of frequency. Bilangin lang natin to. Okay? So all in all, we have 43. Example of frequency distribution. Next, graphical method naman. Actually, we have tatlo, diba? Textual, tabular, and this one is graphical method. It is most effective device for attracting people's attention. Okay? So mas ano siya, mas attractive, no? Mas madali. And although hindi siya, may mga times so madali siyang intindihin, no? Depende sa presentation, no? Pero mas attractive siya doon sa attention ng mga tao, ng mga observer, okay? Kay una diyan, actually we have many types of graphs, eh. Una diyan is yung line graph, no? It is a type of chart which displays information as a series of data points connected by straight lines. Yan, example of line graph. No, yan. Points muna and then connected by straight lines. Okay? So dito mas madaling ma-determine kung progress ba ng isang business, let's say sa business is increasing ba o decreasing. Okay? Yung profit ba ng business is increasing or decreasing. Ganun 'yon for line graph. Or yung number of population ba every year pataas ba o hindi. Kay line graph ang usually ginagamit. Next is yung bar graph, no? It's a chart with rectangular bars with the lengths proportional to the values that they represent. Bars can be plotted vertically or horizontally. A vertical bar chart is sometimes called a column bar. So this one is an example of bar graph, no? Yan. So ma-determine natin dito, no, which sport, no, is most played by students or by a given population, no? So yan, pag so kung si mas madali natin ma-determine, ma-compare no anong laro ang mas nilalaro, anong sport ang mas lalong nilalaro ng mga kabataan. Okay, so here football, no? So example of bar graph. Next naman is yung pie chart naman shows the division of a whole into parts, no? It is a circular chart divided into sectors, each length of which is proportional to the quantity it represent, no? So example of pie chart to. Okay? So dito naman, no, percent na yung ginagamit natin na mga numbers, no, para ma-determine na kung ano yung may mas malaking part. Okay? Next is yung histogram, no? Histogram is a graph showing the distribution of the data that falls within various class intervals. It is drawn with rectangles side by side with the area of each rectangle being being proportional to the frequency of the observations falling into the corresponding class interval, no? So this one is an example of histogram. Ang difference niya doon sa bar graph is that sa histogram dikit-dikit, sa bar graph hiwa-hiwalay, no? To, balikan natin, ha. Yan, no? May spacing pagdating sa bar graph. Sa histogram wala. Okay? Yan. Next is yung pictographs naman, no? It uses symbols or pictures to represent numbers. Now, instead of numbers, pictures or symbols ang ginagamit for pictographs. Okay? Now, let us have an exercise. Analyze the data provided in the charts in the charts and graphs, no? So number one, this pie chart shows the favorite sports of the fourth-year student of National Science High School. Okay, yan. So yun na, pie chart, no? Now, the question is, what percent prefer table tennis? So tingnan lang natin dito. Table tennis, ilan yon? Oh, we have 8%. Okay, number two, what percent prefer basketball? Oh, tingnan natin yung basketball, ilang prosyento? We have 35. Okay, next. If the population is 500 students, how many prefer badminton? Kung sa badminton, ito yon, no? Meron 15%, tapos meron tayong 500 students. So gagawin lang natin, no? Is to multiply 500 times 0.15 is 75. No? Yan. Next, what is the sports that is most preferred by the student of National High School students? Okay? So yung sport talaga na mas prefer ng mga estudyante sa National Science High School. Okay, syempre may mas pinakamalaking percent yun ang mas prepare nila. So here, as you can see, basketball ang mas prepare nila kasi basketball may 35% followed by volleyball na may 25%. Next, among the sports that were named, what is the least preferred by the student? No? Kung yung basketball yung pinaka-most preferred, what is the least preferred naman? Yung pinaka-maliit na percent, yun ang least preferred nila. And that is running. Okay? So madali natin maintindihan pagdating dito sa may graph or sa sabi natin sa pie chart. Okay? That's it. No? So thank you for listening. And again, do not forget to answer your exercises. Your assignment and quiz to be followed na. Okay? So that's all. Goodbye and God bless.